This higher mini-split air conditioner outdoor circuit IPM starts directly. As soon as I provided power, it waits for a moment to activate the PCB. Now it has switched on, and look, it has directly turned on all the IPM IGBTs. These three IGBTs are currently on, as you can see. You can hear a sound from the compressor as well, but it isn't shutting off. The customer's complaint is that the indoor display is showing an F1 error, and as you can see, after a short while, the unit has shut down. Nothing seems to be overheating, but if you look, the IPM has become hot. I will show you its temperature. It has been a little while since I turned it off, but it's still warm. If you check here, the temperature is 135 Fahrenheit. So I'll switch it to Celsius and check again. You can see the temperature is currently showing between 49 and 51 degrees Celsius. Even now, if I touch it without any power, it still feels quite hot. I've now attached the heatsink to the IPM, so I'll check if it is still starting directly or not. The indoor unit is completely off, and we are not turning it on at all, yet the IPM is still starting directly. Now I've reconnected the power, so I'll turn it on again. We'll wait for a moment because it takes some time for the PCB to turn on. Now it has completed the switching, and as soon as it switched, all the IGBTs turned on simultaneously. This means there's some issue with this PCB. Now what I'll do is connect its sensor and also turn on the indoor PCB. The customer complained that an F1 or F01 error is appearing. So let's first discuss what that means according to Haier. The Haier company says this is an IPM protection error. Whenever the IPM overheats excessively, or if the compressor gets disconnected, or if there is an overcurrent due to excessive electricity, the system goes into protection mode and shuts everything down. However, in this case, the IPM is running directly, so what could be the reason for this? My personal opinion, although I haven't done testing yet, is that the IPM might be faulty, which is causing this issue. I've now installed all the components in the system, for example, the sensor, then the motor, and the connection between the indoor and outdoor units. Now, I'll reconnect the power and see what happens. I've turned on the power, and as you can see, the display is now on. I'll turn it on with the remote. As soon as I turned it on, you can see the display showing 16 degrees Celsius. The indoor switch is now on, and the outdoor unit has also completed the switching. So everything is functioning. However, as you can see, none of the IGBTs have turned on directly, even though the compressor is installed and running. So far, we haven't encountered any sounds or short circuits like we did earlier. Now let's wait for some time, because sometimes the system takes 2 to 3 minutes before it attempts to turn on the compressor. Let's see if the F1 error appears again, or if there is another issue on the display, or if we notice anything physically. Also, the compressor connections have been made properly, and I've connected the analyzer to the compressor. The compressor has started properly, as the compressor is running smoothly and the analyzer is also working correctly. Now, I'll check the temperature of the heatsink, and as you can see, the heatsink is currently at 35 degrees Celsius. The compressor has further increased its speed, but the IPM temperature remains stable and there is no fault. It's working perfectly. Now I'm turning it off with the remote and the system has properly shut down. I'll remove it from the system now. The condition is like this. After I turned off the system, I removed the sensors just for testing. Now, let's figure out why the IPM was starting directly. I've tried to find the fault, and I'll show you what the actual cause was and why this issue was happening. So I've turned the system back on for this test. I've removed all the sensors from the outdoor unit, and as you can see, there are no sensors connected here. Now, when I power the system on, it doesn't start directly. The PCB receives its supply from the indoor unit to the outdoor unit, and the power will reach the outdoor unit only when the indoor switching relay switches. I'll turn it on with the remote, and it has already turned on by itself. As you can see, the IPM has started running directly, and you can see all the lights on the analyzer are lighting up. The only thing I did was remove the sensors, and the problem has started again. So this points to a possible cause. Now I'm reconnecting everything directly. As soon as I did that, you can see that the entire system has been restored and is working perfectly, and the issue was only caused by the sensor. My theory is that either the IPM is short-circuited or the system becomes corrupt. When it gets corrupted, the microcontroller sends power directly to the IGBTs, causing them to turn on. To investigate why the IPM is starting directly, we'll run another test. For this, I've created a tester that will check the voltage or signals coming to the IPM, these two points on the IPM are the six pins you see here. This side is for the positive supply, and the other side is for the negative supply. The voltage coming from the microcontroller reaches these points, after which the IPM begins to function properly. The IPM cannot start until the microcontroller allows it. Since the IPM is starting directly, we will use a tester here to check whether the microcontroller is indeed starting it directly, or if there is a fault in the IPM. For this, you can see there are three wires for the positive supply, and the other three are for the negative supply, with the last one being the ground. I'll now connect all of these to the IPM at the points I showed you, the three points and the ground, so we can test it properly. Now, I'll connect all the positive and negative outputs from the microcontroller. I'm applying paste to ensure the performance is optimal. Cleaning the old soldering is crucial because it makes applying new soldering much easier. Sometimes, old soldering can either not adhere properly or not be effective, so cleaning it thoroughly is necessary. Connections that are cut or not well made won't affect performance as long as the three positive connections are with the positive terminals and the three negative connections are with the negative terminals. If not, it could be faulty, or the microcontroller might be faulty. So we need to handle this carefully. I'll apply masking tape to keep the wires in place to prevent them from touching anything that could damage the microcontroller. I've secured everything well, and now the system is ready. I'll carefully back it up to ensure no wires are disturbed, because once it's in place, it will be hard to see anything. Additionally, we need to reattach the heatsink. This is also an important task. We'll carefully place it back, making sure not to let any wires touch each other. Even if the heatsink is upside down, it won't be an issue, but we'll keep it facing up to monitor the system easily. It's best to check everything multiple times before finalizing to ensure there are no issues. Now, I'll use a magnifier to check everything closely. The soldering is complete. However, since the problem occurred without the sensors, I'll turn it on without them for now. I turned it on, and it seems the remote is currently off, so I'll switch it on with the remote. The display shows 16 degrees Celsius. We'll wait for the switching to complete and observe very closely to see if any issues arise. As you can see, the system is running. The supplies are coming from here, but the microcontroller is directly providing these supplies since I didn't connect the supply further. This is why the analyzer isn't working. It's upside down, which is affecting the analyzer's operation. The system supplies are directly coming from the microcontroller, which is causing the problem. We can see that sometimes one light and sometimes another light is glowing. So I'll turn it off for now. Since the compressor is starting directly, we need to observe whether it continues running or not. So first, I'm discharging it. I've discharged both capacitors, so they are now empty. I'll turn the system upside down again and reinstall the supply. First, we'll connect the compressor wires. I'll connect the U wire here, then the V wire. Ensure that the wires don't get disturbed, as all reference wires are temporarily used, and the rest will use the company's system. I've connected all three wires, and now I'll turn the system on again. We'll closely monitor the LED to check if it's working properly. I'll turn off the light, and then turn the system on from above. I've turned on the indoor unit, and we'll wait a moment for it to switch. Now, the supply has reached the outdoor unit, and as you can see, all the IGBTs are on, and there is also an F6 error showing. If the problem is that the sensors are not installed in the system, it's evident that the problem persists. However, once I install the sensor, you'll see that the microcontroller, which was previously stuck, and the other component are no longer stuck. As soon as I installed the thermistor, all the lights turned off, and the other component also turned off. Installing the sensor improved accuracy, and removing it caused issues. The customer's complaint was about an F1 error. Before discussing the F1 error in detail, let me explain what happened. The PCB was faulty, so we replaced it and went to the location where the unit was installed to install to check the PCB. After installing it, we tried to connect the analyzer. However, since we didn't have a soldering iron on site, it was difficult. We cut a few wires to connect the analyzer properly to check if the PCB was working correctly. When we turned on the unit, although the compressor was running, it was making noise. Upon closer inspection, the winding was fine, but the internal pump was completely jammed. This jam caused the compressor to blink twice, indicating a failure. After trying for a while, the unit displayed the F1 error. We then tested another PCB, which was confirmed to be functioning correctly, and found the same issue. The compressor could not start. We concluded that the compressor was jammed and decided not to pursue further repairs. Now, let's talk about the final result regarding why the IPM starts directly without the sensors. To explain this, let's examine the situation where we already have three PCBs, all from the same outdoor unit model. However, all of them are exhibiting the same issue. They are starting the system directly. This likely indicates that either there is a design glitch from the manufacturer or there is a programming flaw causing this behavior. Normally, most PCBs don't behave this way. I hope you have learned something valuable from this video. Now, lastly, I have a request for all my subscribers. As a human, I'm not perfect, and I don't have the knowledge of the entire world. What I do have is the experience I'm going through, which I share with all of you, and I try my best to provide you with as much knowledge as possible. So, I kindly ask all my friends that when you visit my channel and watch the videos, please avoid misbehaving or leaving offensive comments. I am just requesting this. Being human, I am bound to make mistakes, and there should be room for those errors. I'm not a perfect individual, but I share with you everything I experience. To all my supporters, I ask you that if someone comes and leaves a negative comment, please respond to them. I personally do not want to reply to such comments, but with your help, they will get a response. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.